22 seconds left here in the overtime period. LT trailing by two, 52-50. Ray Murphy along with Alex Barkus, Glenbard West playing a great basketball game, as has the Lions Township Lions. On the line in the 1-1 bonus situation is Kevin Moore, the junior guard for Glenbard West, who hasn't made a free throw yet tonight. LT, with only 22 seconds left, just had an offensive foul called on their captain, Matt Finn, at the other end of the court. And Matt wasn't too happy with that, but the situation is Glenbard West has a chance to ice this ballgame. Kevin Moore on the line. Glenbard West up by two. The Hilltoppers in a good situation. LT hoping for a little miracle here. Rebound. Rebound by Owen. Here comes Steve Hahn. 19 seconds left. Kenny Williams with the basketball, works against the pick set by Saul Modestas. Steve Hahn down to Nemesek. Kenny Williams, a sophomore. Oh, yeah! Kenny Williams ties it up. 8 seconds left. 5 seconds left in the ballgame. Here's a prayer. Oh, no good. It's still tied. The sophomore comes through. Kenny Williams, a sophomore, with a 12-foot jumper. We go into overtime again. I think I'm passing out.
Double overtime, a West Suburban Silver Sizzler. Brought to you by the TV Club. Kenny Williams redeems himself after missing that one tough shot. And we have a double overtime game here. Both teams only scored one basket each in that overtime period. And I am telling you, if you got a pacemaker, you better check it out.
I'm going to pass out. Lack of oxygen in my brain. This caused a lot of problems in my life. The crowd all had their coats on. They're ready for the game to end. Everybody peels off their coats now, though. They're ready for another period of action. It's all knotted up here, 52-52, as Kenny Williams, oh, belly, comes through with that shot.
Three more minutes of play. I wouldn't mind if we went to five overtimes. I love overtime games.
Hey, you got to love this game. Senior night here at the Fieldhouse. And the sophomore comes through on that overtime period. As the senior, Matt Finn came through in the first overtime period. The regulation to send it in overtime. Double overtime. And again, Welliver against Owen. Tip one by Glenbard West. Matt Bondi.
Travel. Sven Bondi with the travel.
Gotta love this Lions Township crowd.
Oh, the beginning of the season, it was not too many people here, but they've come out in force, and the Saul section has come alive too, but everyone's into this ball game. A great crowd.
Oh, and underneath, puts it up. There's going to be a foul underneath. They're going to call it a number 52, Joe Hartman, I believe, with the block, as Mike Owen will go to the line. First foul on Hartman. He's a good basketball player. No fouls, great point production, pretty good defense. Mike Owen on the line. Owen has missed an earlier attempt at a free throw. Let's hope he can put it in here. All knotted up, 52-52. Oh!
Gotta love it, gotta love it.
High school basketball at its best. You're seeing it here today. Referee's got to fix the net a little bit.
And mind you, this is with Saul Modestas out. Total team effort.
Saul, their crunch player, sitting on the bench, fouled out the ball game. LT up by one, 53-52. Oh, rebound, Kenny Williams. Oh, taken away by Hartman. LT up by one, 2:42 left here in the overtime period. The second one we've been through. Inside to Hartman. Hartman triple teamed.
Is
rebound
that a
by
foul
Finn, but over the back call.
How many is that on Matt Finn?
I believe that's his second foul.
We've got the chart sitting right above our heads, but.
And Sven Bondi will be on the line. He's 8 for 8. Fourth for Finn. I've missed a couple on him. Oh, don't foul out, Matt. Sven Bondi, excellent basketball player. We can't talk enough about him. Except that he's putting LT away here.
Well, if Matt Finn was to fall out, we'd still have McManaman coming off the bench. He's had a lot of experience. He's a pretty good ball player. And Mark Taylor still could come off the bench.
All tied up, 53-53. Not for long, though. 10 for 10 tonight. Sven Bondi from the free throw line.
That one free throw miss hurt.
LT down by one. It's an uneven ball game with that missed free throw. Steve Hahn! Oh! Three-pointer Steve Hahn! Woo! Steve Hahn from the outside. Teddy Williams with the steal. On the line. Set up by two. Don't force it, guys. Mikovic yelling plays from the sideline. Let's see what the Lions do. They might run down some clock. Matt Finn. Steve Hahn now with the basketball. Kenny Williams on the far side. 1:55 left in the ball game. Finn loses his man for a bit, but holds it up. Steve Hahn to Matt Finn. They're going to hold it a little bit. Here's Finn. Oh, off the glass. Rebound by Nemesis. Scotty Nemesis off the glass with 2 points. LT up 58-54. 1:35 left in the ball game.
Oh, Ray, this is beautiful.
Oh. And Ray Klein, the coach for Glenbard, is upset. This is Cincinnati's crowd, cheer on the line. I tell you, boy, they came on strong there, didn't they?
Oh, yes, they did. And Scott Nemesek, the man coming off the bench there to get the rebound coming out of nowhere, puts it up and in, and that's what you love. The teamwork, the guys coming off the bench and doing their job.
58-54, we're in our second overtime here at the Fieldhouse. A West Suburban Silver matchup between the Lions Township Lions and the Glenbard West Hilltoppers. This has been a great basketball game. You're not going to see really a better played basketball game as far as a fundamental viewpoint. You might see some flashier ball players, but these both these teams, like we talked about, are well coached, run the plays great, and they're smart, heady players. And some gut checks tonight, boy, those jumpers by both teams in the free throws.
2 weeks ago, LT lost a heartbreaker on a three-point shot by Ariel McDonald to lose. They were winning by, I believe, one or two. And it'd be nice for them to win a heartbreaker.
Let's make this a heartbreaker for the Hilltoppers. Joe Hartman bringing it in from out of bounds. 4-point lead for the Lions. 1:30 left in the ballgame. O'Carroll with the basketball, guarded by Nemesek and Williams. Oh! Hartman baseline. Oh, rebound by Finn. Finn will be fouled. Fouled by Hartman. And that'll put Matt Finn on the line. 1-1 bonus. He's made 1-for-2 tonight. But he's second in the conference in free throw shooting, so let's hope he puts it away here.
It's one of the guys you want on the line, Matt Finn.
LT up by four, 1:17 left in the ballgame.
We don't even have to talk much because the atmosphere and the intensity just describes it all.
The senior captain now. Those free throws. 1:12 left in the ball game. LT up by six. Hartman inside, tough move. Rebounded by Sven Bondi. Timeout Glenbard. LT up by four. 1:03 left as Glenbard takes the timeout.
Sven Bondi with 19 points. Big basket for Sven. That's why I guess these two teams have stayed with their opponents. They've got two guys under there who can rebound and put the ball in. And in this conference, it's something you really need. We've got a few outstanding outside shooters, Alonzo Verge and all, but the big men are really important in the West Suburban Silver.
Well, the West Suburban Silver is a tough league. It really is. You see a lot of bodies flying around when any two team in the West Suburban Silver gets together, because they're all aggressive ball clubs. They're playing that way, and that's just the way it is. And it's a tough league, and you have to be strong to survive.
And a game like this can only help these two teams in the state tournament. LT has played a very rigorous schedule. They've played some of the toughest teams in the Chicagoland area, St. Joe's, King, Thornton. They've played tough games on the road, Waukegan East, New Trier, and their conference is tough too, and it can only help them in the tournament. But they got to win this game first.
LT came into this game 10-13 overall, 5-5 in conference. Glenbard West 9-14 overall. 3-7 in conference. Steve Hahn bringing it in from out of bounds. Passes off to Kenny Williams. Kenny Williams, the sophomore, working against a double team. Now to Steve Hahn. Hahn breaks through the pressure. He's going to hold it up a little bit. Smart thinking by Steve Hahn off to Kenny Williams. 50 seconds left in the ballgame. LT up by four. Matt Finn will hold it on top now. Reach-in foul by number 10, Brian O'Carroll. We'll put Matt Finn on the line.
And that'll bring Moore back in the game. I thought he fouled out. No, that was Wagner and Tunin that fouled out.
Also coming in the ball game is Mike Lewis. So his first view of tonight's game from the parquet floor here at Lyons Township High School.
And there you see the captain, Matt Finn.
Fifty-six, 44 seconds left. Matt Finn does not believe in pressure, I guarantee you that. There's ice water running through his veins. Long jumper from the outside, no good. He bought it off by Kenny Williams. Williams will be fouled.
Some words between Kenny Williams and Hartman.
You don't want anything like that to happen.
Pick on someone your own size. Kenny Williams showing some great aggressiveness.
And Hartman has had his Band-Aid ripped off and loose. So, you know, that always hurts.
It does.
The Band-Aid ripped off. But
won't argue on that point.
Kenny Williams will be on the line, 62-56. Kenny Williams came through with that clutch 12-footer that sent this into the second overtime. LT up by 6 points, 56-62. Foul. 30 seconds left in the ballgame. Kevin Moore, three-pointer. Timeout, Glenbard. And just like that, they cut the deficit in half. Glenbard West only trailing by three, 62-59. This is not over.
It's the three-point shot that almost devastated LT against Hinsdale Central. Art Pearson was putting them in, as I told you earlier, he had about nine. And Hinsdale Central came back from a big deficit with that three-point shot.
There's a good view of some of the Glenbard West Hilltoppers.
Ray, what do you do? It's a lingering question in many people's minds. Do you foul the guy going for the three-point shot and make sure he doesn't get it, or you let him take the shot?
Well, in Moore's situation, I would let him take that shot. He really hasn't been offensively productive tonight. And in a tough situation like this, I'd let the junior take that shot. He made it. You got to give him all the credit. But I think LT really is still in the driver's seat in this one. They just have to make sure not to make any mental errors. Lyons Township and Glenbard West, two teams that been around the West Suburban Conference for many, many years. And very old rivals. Glenbard West, one of the older campuses in the conference, had a big campus on the top of a hill, hence the name Hilltoppers. Oh, Kenny Williams runs over his man. No foul call. Kenny Williams on the breakaway. They're going to call a foul on Sven. Sven Bondi with the reach-in. Otherwise, Kenny, I think, was on his way to an easy shot.
But that is fifth. So long, Sven. He is an outstanding player. He's a money player.
Sven's still waiting for the word, I believe. He wants to stay out there as long as possible, get a good look at Kenny Williams, the sophomore. Hey, stick around for this guy. He's going to be an unbelievable ball player in the near future here for Lyons Township.
It's going to be worth coming to the games just to see Kenny Williams in the
last sophomore
next
to start for LT was Elmer Robinson.
Elmer Robinson had an outstanding game against, I don't know, Iowa State was playing somebody. They had not, I believe it was Missouri, that's who it was. And he was putting up the three-point shots like nothing.
Well, he's a great basketball player here for the Lions. And followed in the footsteps of another great LT basketball player that went on to Iowa State, Jeff Hornacek, and now plays for the Phoenix Suns. And this was my graduating class. And I was listening to a basketball tape the other day of Jeff as a junior. And he never thought, he was 6 foot, never thought he'd make it in the pros. Kenny Williams now. Oh! Williams, 6-for-7 from the free throw line.
And I've got him with 14 points.
LT up 63-59.
Ebel and Lewis came back in the game for Glenbard West.
Left. Long range jumper. Air ball. Carroll with the air ball. 10 seconds left. The fans start heading out the exits now.
Is that Moore with the foul?
Oh, Kevin Moore on Kenny Williams. And Williams again will be on the line. And the introduction to Queen, I think, is coming up here now. This chant.
Even the old folks are doing it. I love it. The LT fans are really great tonight.
It's a good look at our student body. seconds left here in the ballgame. Kenny Williams, the sophomore phenom on the line. It's an outstanding game for the Lions. But misses that free throw. 8 seconds now.
Don't foul him.
5 seconds. Oh, three-pointer by Hartman.
Time out with 1 second left.
63-59. LT has it still sewing up. With 1 second left, they'd still have to get the ball in back.
Second three-pointer for Hartman. He's got a remarkable 23 points in this double overtime match. This game isn't over, I'm afraid to say.
But with big ball game, I think, for Lions Township to win this one if they indeed do so, because I think it'll give them some good momentum. Hopefully they can win the next week's game against Downers Grove North, and with those two wins compounded, they could do fairly well in the state playoffs.
I was talking to the McManaman twins a week or two ago, and that's what their goal is and was, to get some momentum going into the tournament, because that's what you need.
It's not much different than the NCAA. All you really want to do is, you know, playing good at the start of the year and being number one and everything is fine, but what you want to do is be playing well once tournament time comes.
Tea time, the big time.
March Madness coming up here soon in IHSA. Steve Hahn getting inbound with 1 second left. What a thriller. A great ball game. Great ball game to be a part of. Final 63-62. Double overtime matchup here at senior night at Lions Township High School. And what a great game to witness. Both teams playing very well. We talked about it earlier. Both teams playing good defensively, but it came down to be a pretty good offensive showcase also.
It was a great game. It was a total team effort. That's the way LT has to win if they want to keep going against Downers Grove North and in the tournament. They have to have a total team effort. Saul Modestus fouled out early, and the rest of the Lions came on strong. Scott Nemesek put in that big basket. Matt Finn put in a couple big ones, and Kenny Williams redeemed himself with the shot that sent it into one of the overtimes.
So the final here from the field house at Lions Township High School, LT on senior night, winning 63-62. For Alex Barkas, this is Ray Murphy. Thank you.
This is the last game of the season for TV Club, and I'm a senior myself. I'd just like to say thanks a lot, Mr. Wiesmus and Mr. Sullivan, all the people here. You've done a great job on the TV Club.
LT against Downers Grove North this Friday at Downers Grove North, so try to get out and see the Lions as they go on to March Madness here. IHSA coming up. Lions playing good basketball.
6-5 in the conference. Good night, everybody. We'll be right back.